Hi, this is Julian from EatTheBlocks. How it's going? For this video, we're going to learn how to use the Ganache GUI. For the last video, we learned how to install Ganache GUI. If you haven't watched this video about installing Ganache GUI, please do it before watching this video on how to use Ganache GUI. First, we will need to download an example smart contract that we will use throughout this video for the example. Then, we will start the Ganache CLI, which is the local Ethereum blockchain that we've been using in previous videos. Next, we're going to start the Ganache GUI, which is the visual tool that we're going to learn during this video. Next, we will configure Ganache GUI to work with the Ganache CLI that we just started before. Next, we will deploy the example smart contract to Ganache CLI and we will be able to visualize it on Ganache GUI. Next, we will read data from this smart contract, write data, and also emit event and see how all of these are reflected or not on the Ganache GUI. The first thing we'll need to do is to download the example smart contract. So for this, you will need to git clone the repository of EatTheBlocks. So go to this URL, or also I put it in the description of this video, and go to the folder of this episode. So that's episode 14. And in this folder, you'll find the contract in the contracts folder. So the contracts and the name is todo. So that is a very simple contract where you have an array of tasks and you have events, foo, and you have three functions. So the first function is a read-only function, getTask. The second function is a write function, so it will actually change the state of the blockchain. And the third function is a function that triggers events. So later, we will call all of these functions and see how this is reflected on Ganache GUI. So open another terminal window and we're going to start Ganache GUI. So for this, we're going to actually use Truffle, which is already configured in this folder. So Truffle develop. Next, we're going to start Ganache GUI. So for me, I downloaded Ganache during the previous episode for episode 13, but if you haven't done so, then it's time to do it. And in the folder where you downloaded Ganache, then you will need to execute the command npm run, and it's going to create an Electron package and start a desktop application. And you should see something like this. Next, we will need to configure Ganache GUI. So by default, Ganache GUI is configured to also start its own instance of Ganache CLI. But in our case, because we are using the Ganache CLI that comes by default with Truffle, then we need to change the default setting of Ganache GUI. So for this, go to the window of Ganache GUI and click on the cog on the top right corner. So that's the icon for the settings. And here, what you'll need to do is to change the port number. So I've already changed it, but you should see a different number by default. So you need to put 9545, which is the port number of the blockchain, the Ganache CLI instance started by Truffle. And the second thing you'll need to do is to change the seed phrase. So for this, click on the account and keys menu. And here you will see the seed phrase, which is basically a series of rows that is used to generate addresses. So I've already updated to the correct one, but in your case, what you're going to do is you're going to go back to your terminal and to the terminal where you started Ganache GUI, and then you will see the seed phrase here. So Ganache CLI mentioned this as a mnemonic. So candy, maple, cake, sugar, etc. So you will need to copy this and to paste it here. Well, I've already pasted it. Okay. And once this is done, you will need to restart Ganache GUI because it needs to restart when you change the setting. So click on restart. Okay. And then everything is sync and up to date. Okay. That's great. If you are curious about this status auto mining of Ganache GUI, it basically means that Ganache CLI automatically mine every transaction into a new block, so you don't need to handle mining, and that's very convenient for development. Next, we will need to deploy the example smart contract, and what we will need to do is to execute the migrate command. So it's going to compile and deploy the smart contract to Ganache CLI. So we just type migrate. Okay, so we've deployed our smart contract. And now we need to have a variable that points to this deployed smart contract. So for this, we're going to define a variable to do. Then we're going to use the contract abstraction object provided by Truffle, which has the same name of our smart contract. So that's to do in our case. Then we're going to call the deploy method, and then we're going to get the result in a then. Okay. For those who followed the previous video, you're probably very familiar with this procedure. That's something that we've done many times before. And now that we have an instance, a variable pointing to our live instance, we will be able to call functions thanks to this variable. Before we start to execute function of our smart contracts, let's check out what happened in Ganache GUI after we deploy our smart contract. So I am on the accounts page of Ganache GUI, where basically I can see all the accounts that we define with our seed phrase when we set up Ganache GUI. And so we can see the address of our different account, then the balance in Ether, and the transaction count. And remember that Ganache CLI by default it pre-fund 10 addresses with Ether. So that's why we can see that we have some Ether for those addresses. And for the first address, we can see that the balance is less than 100 ETH. But for the other accounts, then we can see that they have 100 ETH. So it seems like something happened with the first address. Also, the transaction count of the first address is 3, whereas the transaction count of the other address is 0. So the reason why is because this address was used to deploy our smart contract, and deploying a smart contract costs some Ether. So if we go to the transaction page, what we will see is the transactions that already happen on the blockchain, and we see that 3 transactions happen. And in those 3 transactions, 2 are contract creation. But we just deployed 1 contract. So why is this? So the first contract creation is not our smart contract, but that's a contract that is used internally by Truffle to manage migration. And you can actually see it in the contracts folder. It's called migration.sol, and it's present in any Truffle project, and you should never touch it. And the other contract creation is our smart contract. So if I click on the transaction hash of the second contract creation, one interesting info is the created contract address. And this is the address of the smart contract we've deployed. So we can see that it's smart. It starts by 3, 4, 5, CA, etc. And now an interesting thing we can do is go back to our Truffle console and make sure that we have the same information. So we have this variable to do that point to our deploy smart contract, and we can access its address with the address field. So let's press enter. And what we see, this address start by 3, 4, 5, CA, etc. So we can see that that's the same address that we see on Ganache GUI. So it all makes sense. Now we're going to execute a function of our smart contract, and we will start by the function that write data to the contract. So let's go to the definition of our smart contract to remember what's which function we can access. And so as a reminder, there are three functions, and we will start by executing the write function, which is add task. And this function is going to push a new item to the task array, and it takes as an argument a task name, which is a string. So we're going to provide this for our method call. So let's go back to the Truffle developed console, and we going to use our to-do variable, and our method is called addTask, and this task is going to take our string argument. So I can say buy I don't know, vegetables. Okay, and we going to execute this. Okay, so our transaction was executed. We can see the transaction hash here, and normally we should see the same transaction hash on Ganache GUI. So 0x4EF36. And if I go back to Ganache GUI in the transaction page, I can see that we have a new transaction, and the transaction hash is 0x4EF36, etc. So that's the same transaction hash that we just saw on the Truffle develop console. And this time it's a contract call, so it's not a contract creation. So that's correct. And we can also see the gas that was used. And we can also see the a value field, which indicate how much ether we sent. So we haven't sent any ether. We just paid for the miners with gas. So that's all correct. So now we will execute the read function. So for this, let's go back to the Truffle develop console. And so I'm going to clear my screen first. And then I'm going to execute the function getTask. As an argument, it takes the index of the task in the array. So the first task was created just before, so the index is 0. And then I can see that I can see my task buy vegetables. So it works. But this was not a transaction. It was just a call to the smart contract, and no data was added to the blockchain. So let's see in the Ganache GUI if we see any trace of this. And in the transaction page, we don't see anything. However, we'll still be able to see the call. So let's see in the log. And here in the log, we can see that we just had an API call, F_call. So that's basically our contract call, but that's not a transaction. And just a note of caution here. So let's go back to the transaction page. So in the transaction page, you can see that we have two kinds of transaction. One kind is contract creation. So that's when you deploy a new smart contract. And the other kind is contract call. So that's when you already have a deployed smart contract and you want to execute code in the context of a transaction, which means that potentially any data change will be persisted to the blockchain. But this contract call, we often actually use the same word to talk about another API of Ethereum that allow to execute some code in a smart contract, but not in the context of a transaction. This API call is ETH underscore call that I just showed before. I'll probably prepare a video on this topic, so transaction versus ETH underscore call in the future. But just don't be confused. If you see contract call on transaction page, we are talking of a transaction. We're not talking of just the ETH call API. The last thing we're going to do is to call a function that emits an event and see how we can see this in Ganache GUI. So for that, we're going to go back to our terminal and check out our contract definition. And our third function is trigger event and is going to emit a foo event, which basically gonna contain a description string that we're going to provide to this trigger event function. So to execute this function, we will go back to the Truffle console and we will use our to-do object. And for that, we're going to trigger event. And we need to provide a string, my event. Okay. And so we created a transaction. And so we should see this transaction inside Ganache GUI. So let's check Ganache GUI. And we can see that we have a new transaction. And in this third transaction, we emitted an event. So let's see if we can see any information about our event. And we don't see any info. Okay, so now let's check in the logs. Do we see any event? And no, there is absolutely no trace of the event. There is an API in Ethereum specially for listening to some event, but Ganache GUI is not connected to this API. So we're not going to see anything. Last thing, on the Ethereum blockchain, you have logs. That's where you can see the events. But those logs, they are different that the semantically that this log page in Ganache GUI, because those logs, they are the logs that I capture from Ganache CLI. So it's basically Ganache CLI that report to Ganache GUI, hey, I received this API call, I received this API call. So don't be confused. This log page is the log of Ganache CLI. It's not the events that you capture from the Ethereum blockchain. All right, so now we will wrap up this episode. And now I hope that you feel way more comfortable using Ganache GUI. So if you follow the two videos of this series, you can not only install Ganache GUI, but you can also use it and also take advantage of it to develop smart contracts, because that's what it's designed for. In the next videos, I will finish the series about a to-do distributed application that we started a couple of months ago, because I received a couple of requests about that. Thanks for watching. If you like the content, you can like, you can also subscribe to this channel. And if you have any ideas for some content you'd like to see, please write a comment. Thank you. Bye bye.